Good evening, everyone. This is Adiba Khan, and I'm going to present you a brief session on the basics of Microsoft Excel. Also, during the session, we'll see some practical use cases in sample Excel. So, we'll start with today's agenda, which are introduction, interface, creating or opening workbooks, auto recover, understanding cells, cell content, find and replace, font formatting, text alignment, cell border and fill color, and last one is modifying rows, columns and cells. So Microsoft Excel is one of the documents of Microsoft Office, which is used to create grids of text, numbers and formulas, specifying calculation. Also, it is used to create, to record expenditure and income, plan budgets, chart data, etc. One of the biggest benefits of Excel is its primary function. It has the ability to organize large amounts of data into orderly logical spreadsheets and charts. With the data organized, it's a lot easier to analyze and digest, especially when used to create graphs and other visual data representations. Some of its extensions are .xls, .xlsm, .xlsx, etc. As you can see the interface in the slide, it is the first page when we open a new Excel. Here we can see a blank workbook, which is used to create a new workbook. Also, we have a green panel on the left side, which keeps the track of our recent files. After starting a new workbook, we'll see an interface as shown in the clip here. This window is divided into two parts. The outer part is called application window, whose tags are highlighted by yellow. And the inner part is the workbook window, whose tags are highlighted by green color. So the first one is quick access toolbar, which lets you access common commands, no matter which tab is selected. By default, it includes the save, undo, and repeat commands. You can add other commands depending on your preference. The next one is the ribbon, which contains multiple tabs, each with several groups of commands. We'll use these tabs to perform the most common tasks in Excel. Then we have formula bar, where we can enter data or edit data, formula or a function that will appear in a specific cell. The name box here displays the location or name of a selected cell. So Excel has a variety of viewing functions that change how your workbook is displayed. So we can choose to view any workbook in normal view, page layout view, or page break view. These views can be useful for various tasks, especially if you're planning to print the spreadsheet. Now we have zoom control. To use these features, we have to click and drag the slider. The number to the right of the slider reflects the zoom percentage. The sheet one here is a worksheet Excel file. This is also called workbooks. Each workbook holds one or more worksheets, also called as spreadsheets. Now the last one is the scrolling button. These buttons scroll the display of sheet tabs one at a time, or to display the first and last grouping of sheet tabs. And they are located to the left of the sheet tabs. Now we'll see how to create open workbook. So to create a new workbook, we'll select the file tab and back stage view will appear. Then select new and click blank workbook. A new blank workbook will appear. And to open an existing workbook, we'll navigate to backstage view, then click open. Like this, then we'll select computer and click browse to locate the file. Next topic is auto recover. This is a very cool feature where Excel automatically saves our workbook to a temporary folder while you are working on them. If you forgot to save any changes or if Excel crashes, you can restore the file using auto recover. So as you can see in the snip, if you open the Excel after it crashes, then we'll see a document recovery panel which shows our last working file even if we don't save it. Next is understanding cells. So every worksheet is made up of thousands of rectangles, which are called cells. A cell is the intersection of a row and a column. Columns are identified by A, B, C, D, E, etc. And row is identified by 1, 2, 3, 4, etc. Each cell has its own name or cell address based on its column and row. In this example, the selected cell intersects column C and row 5. So the cell address is C5 here in the second cell. Note that a cell's column and a row headings are highlighted when the cell is selected. Here in the first snip, the cell has a column A over here and row 1. And if you see in the second snip, the selected cell has a column C and row 5. So its cell address will be C5. Next topic is cell content. So any information you enter into a spreadsheet will be stored in a cell. Each cell can contain several different kinds of content, including text, formatting, formulas, and functions. The cells can contain text such as letters, numbers, and dates. It contains different formatting attributes that change the way letters, numbers, and dates are displayed. For example, percentages can appear as 0.15 or 15%. You can even change a cell's background color. It also contains formulas and functions that calculate the cell values. In our example, sum B4 is to B7 adds the value of each cell in a cell range B4 is to B7 and displayed the total result in cell B8. So the total sum is 155. So we'll see this quickly in demo. I have already created a table as we have seen in the PPT. So now we will write an add method in a cell which will sum number of students in the table. So equal to sum, which is the function. Double click on it. Click on this. This to B6. Then the sum will be calculated. 154 is the total sum. If you want to take out the average, you can also do that. Average function is there. Average will be there. Now we have a very simple topic, find and replace. When working with lots of data in Excel, it can be difficult and time consuming to locate specific information. You can easily search your workbook using find feature, which also allows you to modify content using the replace feature. We'll see this practically. So like I have written some of the data, and here there is find and select option. We'll click on find. So if you want to find anything like Monday, find all, then the cell number and everything will come. A5 is the column and 5 is the row. And this is small letter. If we'll write on big letters, so it will show this one. And if you want to replace it by Friday, then it will get replaced here. And this one will also get replaced. All Mondays will be replaced by Friday. So now we'll talk about font formatting. Font formatting is very essential feature, which is based to make our document attractive and more readable form. By default, the font of each new workbook is set to Calibri. However, Excel provides a variety of other fonts you can use to customize your cell text. We'll see the next topic and then cover both practically. Next topic is text alignment. This feature is used to align the text inside any cell. By default, any text entered into your worksheet will be aligned to your bottom left of a cell. Any numbers will be aligned to the bottom right of the cell. Next is cell borders and fill colors. Cell borders and fill colors allow you to create clear and define boundaries for different sections of your worksheet. Now let's see this practically. So this is my Microsoft Excel, and I've written some of the words. So like for this one, if you want to change the font style and all, so Calibri is the default one and it's already there. So we can choose any one of them. Like I have chosen Arial Black, then it will be like this. And if you want to do font bold, italic, it's already in bold. Then underlined. Then if you want to change the font color, the color will be changed. Then if you want to align, then I'm gonna highlight this, then get highlighted. Then we can increase or decrease the font size. Then these are the alignments. Like if you want, it will move vertically and this will move horizontally. So this is the wrap text, so it works like this. Like MS Office is a document. Like I've written this and I want to merge, wrap this text, so it will come into one cell like this. The text will be wrapped. Okay, so these are all the features. So I'm showing you the border one. So these are the border, top borders. Like here I want to do as a bottom border. So a border will come here. See, like when it has. So now we'll see how to modify columns, rows, and cells. By default, every row and column of a new workbook is always set to the same height and width. Excel allows you to modify column width and row height in different ways, including wrapping text as I've shown, and merging cells. Let's have a quick demo. So like we can modify the height and the width. So move like this, it will increase and the row will move like this. So we can adjust according to our preference. And can also do auto format like this one. We click on format, then auto row column width, then auto row. It will fit into one cell. It won't take the extra space.
Let's have a quick demo for various formulas and functions used in Excel. So these are very useful in a daily work. So this is the list of all basic functions. So let's start. So first I'll show you add, subtract, multiply, divide, and sum. So if we write any number and we give it, equal to, then we'll select the first number, then the second number, the result will come. Now if I want to subtract 36 minus 17, then I select the first, then minus 17, the result will come. Then if I want to divide 22 and 56, then select this, multiply 56, then divide. I want to divide this with the 57 or 76. Then if I divide this by this, then the answer will come. And the sum is the function. When we will write sum, then we select it, and if we want to sum all the numbers, close bracket, then we'll get the result. So we don't have to write plus or minus, we'll just select the cell and we'll get the result. So next we go to maximum, minimum, average, and median. So maximum means we will find the maximum of the ranges of numbers we have. So how to find this? Equal to max. We have a function max. Then select all these numbers, close brackets, and the maximum number is 82,000. This one. Now, if we find out the minimum, then we write NIN. Now, we select the range again, close bracket. 3200 is the minimum number. Average, if you want to find average, then same technique, average, and select all the numbers, close bracket, and the average will come. And median, so median is used to calculate the middle number. So if I write equal to median, and I select all the numbers, so the result will come 12,000, which is the middle number. Now we next see concatenate function. So concatenate means, like, when we concatenate cells in Excel, we combine only the contents of those cells. In other words, it joins two or more values together. Like if I want to join Microsoft and Office, so will be equal to concatenate, and if we select the cells, comma, Microsoft Office will come. And if we want to give space between them, then we can give inverted comma and a space, then the space will come between them. Okay, next is trim function. So trim, it is used to remove the spaces between any numbers. Like if I write Microsoft Excel and give a lot of space between them. So like if I select trim, I select this text, so it will remove the extra spaces. Now we'll go to the next function, which is if, countif, and sumif. So first we'll see for if. So the if function can perform a logical test and return one value for true result and another for a false result. So for example, I'm showing you, like, I have written smile. And if I want to do if this cell is equal to inverted comma smile, then it will say yes. If not, then it will say no. So yes, smile is there, so it is saying yes. And if I put another word as start, so it will print no, the smile is not there. Another is countif. So countif is an Excel function to count cells in a range that meet a single condition. Count cells that matches criteria. Okay, so like we write count if, we select the range. And our criteria is like, I want to get 10. Then, okay, so 3 times 10 has been occurred. 1, then 2, then 3. 1, 2, 3. And next is sumif. So the sumif function will add all numbers in a range of cells based on one criteria. Like, I have given an example, like, I've written Alex got 50, Kelvin got 20, and I have given 2 Kelvin. So what will I do? Equal to sum it, I'll write the range, these are the range, then criteria I want to get Kelvin, and the sum range I want to sum this one, so 65. So Kelvin 20 plus 45, 65 will come. So these are the function. Now we'll go to the next function. Next we'll see exact function and current time function. So in exact function, it compares two strings and it returns false if both the values are the same. Otherwise, it will return false. So like equal to exact. So two strings. So first we'll give this one, comma, this one. So is this string? No, false. So it is not same. Month name 1 is May and month name 2 is June. So if I drag, so this one is true because August and August are same. That's why we get true. Now next is current time. So it is used to know the current type by now command. Like if I do now, then sorry, I forgot to give it. Yeah, so it will give the current date, time, and everything. Next we'll see sub total function. So sub total means to total everything. So if you write equal to sub total, so there will be many options. Like we can do average, count, count a, max, minimum. So whatever we want to do, we'll just write the number. Like if I want to do sum, then write 9. And comma, I'll select the range. So the total sum will be given. Like if I want to find the average, then that also I can do. Like 1. Comma, the range. So I'll get that. So next we come to the count function. So the Excel count function returns the count of values that are numbers, generally cells containing numbers. So for example, if I put equal to count, then I'll select all the ranges. We have 20 numbers over here. And count a function counts cells containing any type of information, including error text and empty text. So like if I select count A, and if I select then 22. The number, the word alphabet will also be calculated. And count blank, so it counts the blank cells in a range. Like if I want to select this one, then it will be counted all the blank cells. Now next is VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP. So V stands for vertical, and the VLOOKUP function performs a vertical lookup by searching for a value in the first column of a table and returning the value in the same row in the index number position. So the VLOOKUP function is a built-in function in Excel that is categorized as a lookup or reference function. So for example, I have created a table and I want to find out the donation for Shilpa. So the formula for lookup is V lookup. Then the lookup value I want to find for Shilpa, comma the table range. So I select the table range equal to the column index number. So I want to find out the donation 2016. So it's in column 2. So I give 2, and the exact match will be there. So 700 Shilpa 700. So like this, it will be find out. Now next is H lookup table. So the H lookup function, it performs a horizontal lookup by searching for a value in the top row of the table and returning the value in the same column based on the index number. So the H lookup function is a built-in function in Excel that is categorized as a lookup reference function. So now we'll see for H lookup. So first, this is vertical. So first we'll change it to horizontal. So we'll copy and we'll paste as a transpose. It will become horizontal. And so like this it will come, and it will reflect the same thing. And we'll copy this. And again, we'll paste as a transpose. So we'll remove this. And the formula for so the formula for H lookup is equal to H lookup. The lookup value we want to find for Shilpa. Then next is table array. So we'll select the table from here. And next, if you want to select the row index, like if I want to find for donation 2016, so it's in second, or write 2, comma, 0. So it will get 700 for Shilpa. Like the same, it will come. So these are the function for VLOOKUP and HLOOKUP. Next, we'll see for left, right, and mid function. So for left function, it will retrieve a specific number of characters from the left side of a string. For example, if I write left, then like if I want this one is at the left and the numbers are at the right. So like if I want to A3, and A3 means I have to select the text and characters. So I have to select the characters like Mumbai is of 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 6 characters. So if I do that, then Mumbai will come. Then same for others. And for right, I'll select right, then the text, comma, the characters are 6. So it will get printed. Next is mid. So mid function, so it will get a specific number of characters from the middle of a string. So if I put mid, then the start number, the text, first I'll select the text. Then like if I want to print the by, B-A-I, day, Mumbai. So by I want to print, then the characters are starting from 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 and the total B-A-I are of 3 characters. So I'll do that and by will be printed. Like if there will be different, like over here I have come across, like if there will be different countries like Mumbai, Bangalore, Pune, then how we'll do that. So this we can do by we'll select data, we'll select this. And we'll go to data, text to column, then next, then like I want to give hyphen, and it will show like this as a result, then next, then finish. So this will go to the next column. So next is the repeat command. The repeat command can be used as many times as required to repeat a previous action and repeat the command entered on one cell on the other cell. So like for example, we have a repeat command. Select this. Then if you want to give stars or anything, like if I want to give stars, then like this, and how many times I'll select this one. Then 5 stars will be printed, and according to that, I can change the star, I can give another symbol also, whatever according to our choice. So last one is substitute function. The substitute function, it replaces the text by matching. So for example, we give equal to substitute. And if you want to remove the hyphen between the text, so we'll select the text, comma. Now we want to replace the hyphen sign equal to by, like if I want to replace it by space. So the hyphen sign will be removed. Then if I want to replace the comma with the hyphen sign, so it will be substitute, then the text, then comma, then the hyphen sign, then the comma sign. I want to remove the comma sign with hyphen. So this will be removed. Okay, same for this also. If I select the text and okay, that's all about the function and formulas.
So now let's summarize what all we have covered. So what is Microsoft Excel? Excel interface, how to create and open workbooks, auto recover, understanding cells, different rows and columns, then cell contents, find and replace feature, then font formatting, how to align the text, then cell borders and fill colors, and last, how to modify columns, rows, and cells. We'll send the assessment link with all of you through mail, and please do attend it. Thank you very much, and have a nice day.